Hey, welcome. It's Dr. Christine Bradstreet of Change Your Mind, Change Your Life. We're talking about chronic pain and chronic nuisance symptoms that are the result of the mind-body connection and or the neural circuit loop. So as you know, chronic pain and other types of chronic stress-related symptoms like digestive problems, food sensitivities, migraine headaches, menstrual cramps. Somebody asked me about burning mouth syndrome. I had to look that one up. Absolutely, I would say that falls into this category as well. Restless leg syndrome. There's a very long list of symptoms that aren't easily explained by traditional medicine because they are the result of a mind-body connection, a little faulty circuit that got hardwired between your brain and your body, and you're coming here to learn how to change that. So welcome. So today's topic is unspoken messages. I think a couple times in past videos, I've used the example of a coin. A coin has a head side and a tail side. So an unspoken message, think of it as the tail side of a coin. So I'll give a couple examples. If you always put some sort, you know, those elastic straps, elastic waistbands that you can wear around your back to help supposedly support your back or prevent injury, well, side note, I'm a retired chiropractor. I study the science, and those elastic supports do absolutely nothing to prevent injuries or to stop back pain. So that's a side note. But going back to the theme of today's video, so maybe you've been wearing these elastic waistbands to help support, or you think that it's supporting your low back. What is the flip side of that coin? That the flip side thought of that is, naturally, well, I have a weak back, so I have to wear this elastic support. And the subconscious mind and your mind are very good at picking up on the unspoken flip side of the coin. So here are a few more examples. Do you take a handful of supplements? Do you take a handful of anti-inflammatory supplements like maybe fish oil or ginger or turmeric? These things all purportedly reduce inflammation. What's the flip side belief when you take a handful of supplements like that for inflammation? The flip side is you're telling your brain, I have inflammation. The brain is very good at doing your bidding. So whether or not it actually creates inflammation in you, it's going to create a feeling to make you believe you have inflammation. Another example, do you have a prolonged stretching routine that I hear some people say, if I don't stretch for 20 minutes in the morning when I get out of bed, you know, I can't function during the day. Well, the flip side is that you've taught your brain, actually I said it out, some people say it out loud, you can't function if you don't stretch for 20 minutes per day. But the unspoken message is, I have tight muscles, I better stretch for 20 minutes. And finally, I had a friend once, very health conscious, and he started every morning with what he called his high vibe smoothie. He would, you know, take all sorts of good fruits and veggies, but also a whole bunch of supplements that I can't even pronounce, and put it into this smoothie and drink it every day. Well, one day, I believe he slept late, he didn't have time to make it, and it almost put him in a state of anxiety or worry, thinking that he wasn't going to function at his fullest capacity because he didn't have his high vibe smoothie that morning. Well, that's the flip side of the coin. He was putting so much faith into this slurry that he drank out of a glass that because he missed it one day, he truly was concerned that he was not going to function. So this is the danger of even healthy habits. You know, it's sure, it's healthy for us to stretch and get exercise and eat a well-balanced, healthy diet, but when you count on them, when you do them ritualistically, you're brain is picking up on the unspoken and maybe even unaware message that you're sending it. When I offered to him the possibility that along with the belief that this high vibe smoothie gave him high vibes, that came along with the belief that if he didn't drink it, he was going to have low vibes. Well, that's not true. That's not how the human body works. So again, it's not an excuse to go out there and eat junk food all day and do whatever unhealthy habits you feel like doing. But be confident that if you have a reasonable amount of activity in your life, if you eat a reasonably good diet, if you're getting a reasonable amount of sleep, that that's a healthy lifestyle and that you don't need to rely on pills, powders, and potions to express your truest health or to live a pain-free, symptom-free life. So that's your assignment. Take a look at where you might be giving your conscious or subconscious mind messages of danger. The flip side of the coin is a message of danger to your brain. Uh-oh, I didn't drink my smoothie. Uh-oh, I didn't do my 20 minutes of stretching. Uh-oh, I didn't take my handful of supplements. So your assignment is to take a look and uncover what some of these unspoken messages are that are going to your conscious and subconscious mind. Because when you can stop those, when you can summon up enough courage to break those rituals, break those routines, feel confident in yourself, whether or not you drink that smoothie, whether or not you took those supplements, that is when you can recover and break the cycle of chronic pain and chronic symptoms. All right, this is a bit of an advanced teaching today, but I know that if you've been here following along, you'll understand it, and I know that you'll be able to uncover some really juicy tidbits of information. I'll see you in a couple days on the next video. Again, I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet of Change Your Mind, Change Your Life. Bye-bye.